They always have interesting conversations.
I do.
See who goes first. Did I bring rock, paper, scissors? Aha! There you are, bud. Guys. Let's do this.
By the way, if you want my Grand Prix Charlotte sleeves that I haven't opened yet, I'll give them to you.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Dude, you're awesome. It would be helpful, if for no other reason than I wouldn't have to keep changing sleeves out for the modern and the legacy version of this deck.
Mm.
Is mine. You pick yours. Da da da
da. Om nom 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 nom.
And then there's Caesars.
Yep.
Alright. So I think lately what that means is that you'll win the rock, paper, scissors on the next one. Mm-hmm. Because I think I've been on a back and forth streak.
Gotcha.
For a bit. Alright. Can't keep.
I can, and will.
Okay. No land hand, man.
Oh, yeah, you can't do that. Cannot do that.
I just realized when it's so zoomed in, like when you just see it on the card, oh, there's a bunch of ravens or vultures or something like that. It's a murder of crows. But then when it's so zoomed in, those are just like, he just took this paintbrush and went...
Yeah.
And yet it still looks kind of badass.
Yeah.
I think, anyway.
Definitely. I really do like the arm on the card. Even though I've never used the card or anything, I've always wanted to get, like, a playset and just go for something.
He's like, to me, he looks like Erebos trying to swag out.
That's true.
You're a good six. Come on, buddy. T1 Glistener Elf, don't fail me now. Or whatever. Okay, I'll keep.
Okay.
And then let's get that scry on. Let's shove that. And we'll start off with... Dun dun dun! Pastor. So, these life titles, they mean jack all in this match.
Yeah,
all that we care about is this life total right here.
The Theatre of War.
Yes.
Go ahead.
All right. End of turn. Fetch. But I had been calling Catheter of War for a bit. For that exact reaction. Sometimes you'll get, like, cringing just at the thought.
Things that make you go, oh.
Yeah. Like, I don't know, it's a silly name, like calling Psalm Simulacrum, or Simulacrum, Sad Robot. Just, aww, poor guy looks so sad.
Yeah.
And then he didn't look sad anymore because he didn't have any expression at all in the next printing. Okay. So if the turn one play is Cathedral, Noble, pass turn.
Where you go?
I don't know. I gotta run back over there.
Obviously, the top deck.
I gotta run back to school and make sure shop down one.
Wind sweat.
Okay.
And I will pass.
Yeah, man.
You what?
For some reason, I was thinking Clutch was a sorcery.
It is sorcery.
It is?
Yeah.
Okay. I thought Damon said it was an instant.
You're okay with it because it's a one drop.
Yeah, I could have swore Damon just said, I can't believe it's an instant. I was like, wait, it is?
God, I wish it was. We found a 2-drop instant that bounces.
It's a dude?
Mm-hmm. Right.
But I'm okay not playing it. It's a 1-drop sorcery, sure. But it's a 1-drop, and you can buy it back with the dive calling.
Yeah.
Any card will make it, they essentially have 2 copies of it because of time calling.
Yeah,
for coffee there. I should have Stain to Mind the next counter spell somewhere. I think I had a set. I think
we can do this now. Pendlehaven Pond?
Mm-hmm.
That's up there in the play in the deck.
Main phase Might of Old Krosa?
Finger Swans?
Really?
Dismember?
Really?
Really?
Okay.
I want something fun to board.
I will show you something in my hand after this. Okay. Pass turn.
Correct.
Now, normally I don't do what I just did, especially given that this is in my hand, but you said you did this based on my list. I did not see Dismember coming because I did not run Dismember.
Well, I said the original deck was based on your list.
I actually don't think I've ever run Dismember in the... Oh, maybe it was a 1-0. Okay, yeah, original one was based on. All right. Yeah, so I'll show you, if I lose, which I might, I'll show you. I did something very, very different than what I normally do, based on that assumption.
Sideboard, displacement wave. That's
Ichor
Claw,
depends on
the place.
Ichor Claw mirror.
Ichor Claw is good.
We'll pass the turn, sir.
Alright. Spellskite? That's something that I could have done. I could have played that first. I could have been a contender.
Could have.
Yeah. I was running through thinking, wait a minute, did I ever run anything like that? No? Okay, I'll just go for it. Yeah. That was my reasoning.
Gotcha.
Yeah,
alright. Pastor?
Okay. Interesting infect deck that mains boards Spellskite.
Yeah, it's just a one of. It's good for fighting not just Infect, but Bogles, Twin. There's a number of decks that Spellskite does a good job, and it just protects my creatures too. But still, it's just a one of, at least in the main board. You don't see it too often.
Necropede.
Hi, Necropede.
Go to combat.
Okay.
Swing.
Perfect. I have 3 flash
wheels.
That's exactly what I want.
4 dose.
I'll take 2.
Alrighty.
Why did I put the dice on that side of the tripod? That seems like a good way to do it.
And I will pass the turn.
Okay. It's a dude?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's a bigger dude?
Mm-hmm.
Combat?
Okay.
3?
Alright.
1, 2, 3? Yep. Move on.
Alright. Main phase 2?
Mm-hmm.
getting a forest.
I have to tell you about an interesting interaction with one of the cards in my hand in Spellskite later.
Oh boy. Blighted Agent?
Yep.
End of turn, stops being a creature. Pass turn. Oh man, both of us are getting a little bit flooded, I guess, for effect decks.
Yeah, just a little.
Blight Mamba, okay. Regenerate means a lot in the infect patch. But yeah, that's fair.
I put that in for all the people that played Burn.
Oh yeah. I will block your Tasker all day, every day.
But I only have to block him a few times before he dies.
That's it.
Combat?
Yep. Block.
Okay.
Yeah, yours will die at end of turn, but
yep.
It will die. Yeah. We're just getting to that.
It will. And... Master?
Go to 16.
Mm-hmm.
It's a dude.
Yep.
Friendly UAV inbound.
Combat? Exalted trigger. Before we get to damage, five.
Become immense.
In response.
All right.
Fine.
Redirect. Pay two life.
Okay. So, yeah. Yeah, you have game one, sir.
Thank you. Okay, so that was... There is no other instance when I don't play the Spellskite before attacking like that unless I really think I know your deck, and... I thought I did, but I got punished for that so hard. That was good. The dismember there, that was pretty sweet. That was really good. And it's just basically, I mean, it's not even snuff out. You don't care about the life in this match.
No, and the interesting thing is if you vines
yep.
A Spellskite, your opponent can still redirect all your stuff even though it says they can't be the target of spells that they control.
It's a fun, weird way of doing it, but yeah. Vines of Vastwood is... Interestingly, it's never been errated to Hexproof, so just like Stinkweed Imp has never been errated to Death Touch.
Yep.
And so if you get Stinkweed Imp to fight another creature, you know, it has to actually deal combat damage to kill them like that. Anyway, enough of that. We'll see you in game two. That's the job done. Now, before we get started, I do want to show one of the... altars that we have here at the Missing Piece. The owner Josh has been cool enough to let me show off. This is a Tom Rost signed Berserk, the beer at the top. Swear, if I actually get to add this to one of my decks, my Legacy Infect deck, I'm gonna ask him what kind of, because you can look and the brand of beer is scribble. It's just this like squiggly line. Squiggly line, I mean. I want to ask him what his favorite brand of beer is. Somehow, I want to put him on a... I'm hoping that he roots for my hometown and it's like Terrapin or Creature Comfort, something like that.
Gotcha.
Oh, I say hometown. I was in Athens for long enough that it kind of felt like my hometown. Oh, by the way, you're first, so...
Yes, and I will keep.
I will keep as well, yes. Alright. So I'll go and put that back on the counter. No, this is our new poison counter. Mwahaha!
Alright, let's start off with an ink moth.
That seems good.
Best turn.
I'll go to 17 to play a Noble Hierarch off of a breeding pool, and then I'll do this so you can be taking your turn, and then I'll pass the turn. Yeah. So the only Magic player that I've ever gotten to talk to for, all right, going to 19. For any decent amount of time was Tom Ross. I've gotten to say hi to other Magic players, mostly at GPDC and SCG Atlantas. But Tom Ross actually critiqued my Infect deck, and he was a really, really nice guy about it. He was constructive, and he told me just flat out, he didn't think that my deck was ideal, and I said, yes, I don't have any Force of Wills, and he said, oh. Because my bug Infect list was... basically, Ari Laxes from Pro Tour Return to Ravnica brought to Legacy. So it did not have any counter spells except Daze, and it didn't really have any good card draw other than Gitaxian Probe. So the deck really could have been much, much better. But I didn't have any Force of Wills and thought I shouldn't go down that road as a result. Necrobate. Okay.
I'll pass the turn.
Spellskite? Glistener Elf? Pass turn. I had to refrain from the T1 because I was afraid he was going to die again to a dismember. I think this one's a she. The promo one's a she. Maybe the regular one's a he.
Gotcha.
Not like it matters, but... Alright. In before, Viridian Corruptor, Nature's Claim.
Pendlehaven.
Both. You're mono green. I would be very surprised. Not... Okay, I'll redirect that to Spellskite.
Yep.
Yeah, you almost got that one by me.
Go to combat.
All right.
Declare an attacker.
Block.
Okay. Let's go ahead and pump Necropede.
Okay. Necropede is a 2/3. I can't redirect that, obviously.
No. And we will... obviously the two negative counters will go on Spellskite.
Yeah.
When he dies, the one that comes off of him will go to Glistener Elf.
I'll redirect, and actually I needed to take life from the previous one anyway. So I'll go to 11. Yeah, that's what I was reading to make sure that worked.
Right.
So he is at 3. Minus one counters.
Okay. And I will pass turn.
Yeah. There is no way that this does not go poorly for me if I just go for it blindly like that.
I'm gonna shout here first.
See? This guy. Love it.
Darcy, start Hershey first.
Hardy, hardy, hard.
Noble Hierarch?
Yep.
Come back?
Mm-hmm.
Swinging.
He starts. There's.
Okay.
Mutagenic Growth.
Okay, so final.
All right, put you to five. That's it.
Alrighty then.
All right, and pass turn, yeah.
Move your back, all right? Hmm. Cover your right
side,
right back, all right?
Correct.
Okay.
It's never fun to get flighted with impact.
Man, you are not kidding me. He's like the Swedish chef over there.
Hurdy, hurdy, hurdy.
No, it's everything in reverse.
Oh. So now you know someone's gonna play this backwards and they're gonna hear like, hail Satan, or something like that.
Hail Satan!
I will pass turn, sir.
Alright.
You
are your death match.
No, if you were the Swedish chef, it'd be like, hurdy, 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 hurdy.
So there's the obvious play here. I mean, it's not like you don't see it, so I might as well say. If I swing with the Glistener Elf, he blocks with the Ink Moth, it doesn't get through, and then Glistener dies at the end of turn. We would just trade with each other. And then it's sort of a race to see who gets the next infect creature.
Oh, come on.
I'll do it. I'll make it. Swing three.
It's a dude.
Oh!
Right. Call for the block.
It's a pump dude.
Okay.
It's a pro green.
Oh.
Dude.
There we go. There we go.
Then right. We block.
Well, in that case, there is no trade.
We can't. It's target creature I control.
Oh, okay, okay. Never mind, never mind. You're right. It's not Vines of Vastwood.
That's right. Makes you feel a little bit better.
Okay. Okay. There we go, then. It actually does, just a little bit. Alright. Pass turn.
Well.
Well played, well played. Hey!
Angel.
That's pretty good.
It's a dude.
It's a dude, alright.
It's punk dude.
It is.
Swing three.
That's three at me. Upkeep? Oh, I assume you're done with it. Yeah.
Yep.
Upkeep.
Fetch. The other thing, I should just hit you for regular damage.
We're getting there. Oh, if only. And then I'll
G-probe, huh?
Yeah, I'll do that.
I become immense.
Okay, I mean, that one doesn't matter so much, but okay, that's fair. Say, this is actually kind of embarrassing, but I'm trying to remember what Spellskite's power is right now. It's obviously a one toughness creature.
It's a negative one. No, it's a.
I was about to say negative one.
But if you attack because of your exalted, it would be one.
Okay, I was trying to remember if making it negative power actually brought it negative, or if the lowest it was allowed to go was zero.
No, it can actually go negative.
Okay, fair enough. That's. That makes more sense. Okay, in that case... Might of Old Krosa? We're doing it. We're doing it.
Go.
I'm trying. I am desperate, as we can tell. Become immense on the same?
Okay.
Alright, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Swing 12.
Okay.
We're doing it.
Go to 5.
This is dumb, and I know it. I will pass the turn. If at first you don't succeed, destroy all evidence you ever tried.
That's sagely advice. See what happens. Mike?
He's in the corner.
Redirect to Spellskite? Six.
Pass turn. See if you got it.
I do. Sorry. The top deck of glory. The other one was just an apostle's blessing, so that wasn't going to do me anything.
Nope.
Oh god, you can't block me with your artifact.
I guess there's that.
That could have been that.
Yeah, good job.
Yes, sir.
So, I forgot to bring my sideboard with me, but the only card I would have sided in anyway, I think, is Viridian Corruptor. I could also side in Nature's Claim for Inkblock.
I did sideboard in Nature's Claim, but I didn't see one.
That makes a lot of sense in this match. So just randomly infect wounds with life point damage, that happened. So dismembers, or more dismembers brought in?
More dismembers.
Makes sense.
And then nature's claim.
Good. I don't know, maybe you should, maybe Viridian Corruptor is worth a slot. I remember Peter Geiger's list, he ran, I think that's how you pronounce his last name. He ran one or two in the main. But then again, that may have also just been a meta choice for a lot of affinity decks. Nowadays with Lantern Control, it gets a little bit better.
I do those for affinity decks.
Yes! You can you can get there. How many lands are you running, dude?
18.
Oh, well...
Well, 18 plus a playset of Cathedral of War.
Oh, okay. That'll do. 18 Forest and 4 Cathedrals?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, 14 Forest.
Oh, okay.
4 Ink Moth, 4 Cathedral.
Okay. Yeah, I'm sorry. You're right. Ink Moth, of course. Don't! Do you run the Sylvan Scrying package?
No.
It's maybe something.
I might as well show it to you.
Okay, sure.
Alright, we run a place. I think we run 3 Ichor Claws.
Okay.
3 Blight Mambas.
Good.
3 Glistener Elves.
Oh, you broke my heart. Just 3?
Well, I cut one of every creature that I ran in order to add the Blight Mambas because too many people run Burned.
Okay.
And I needed the regeneration. We also run 3 Necropedes.
Okay. Let me give you my Infect tier list, if you don't mind my...
That's fine.
Top tier, tier 2, tier 3, tier 4. I mean, they're all useful. This is just my personal preference.
4 Cathedrals, 4 Ink Moth.
Yeah.
I run a playset of Windswept just for thinning.
Good, good.
Playset of Rancor.
Okay. And always, you can always represent Path with Windswept Teeth.
That's
one thing I like to do with it.
Playset of Mutagenic.
Yeah.
Groundswell.
Very nice.
I think we cut down to 3 Groundswells.
Might of Old Krosa is in there, I assume?
Yeah.
I mean, wait, yeah, I did see that. That's right.
Yeah. Might of Old Krosa.
Yeah.
I do Become Immense as a 2 of.
Fair enough.
I do Dismember as a 2 of main board.
Good.
And then Apostle's Blessing as a 4 of.
Makes good
and
sense.
And that's the whole deck. I mean, it's.
4 Vines, right?
Straightforward, yes. Vines. I forgot the Vines.
Yeah, in Modern. So
I think I probably passed the Vines.
In Legacy, I run 3 Vines of Vastwood and some counterspells. In Modern, I run 4 Vines and 2 Apostle's Blessing because Lightning Bolt is the most played card in this format.
Yes, it is. And
so,
glad you said Vines because I left them in the sideboard.
That makes sense, yeah.
But I sideboarded those out because they don't mean anything against Spellskite, so.
Yeah, they don't. It's only a 1 of. It just decided it wanted to show up both games. It's nuts like that. It doesn't want to do that when I'm playing against Twin, but when I'm
right.
playing against Infect, it's a mirror breaker.
It's definitely straightforward, balls to the wall. Infect counters.
I like that. I like that. Just as a recommendation, one thing you could try, and you can do this mainboard, you can do this sideboard. I like putting some number of Sylvan Scrying in the deck,
mm-hmm.
and then having utility lands in the main and the sideboard.
Right.
Like a 1 of Ghost Quarter in the main and a Bajuka Bog in the side, or you know stuff like that. That you can go and get your Cathedrals in the main. You can go and get your Inkmoth Nexus, so
right
Sylvan Scrying kind of turns into
Boy,
a creature.
Yeah.
Know?
The thing is for graveyard decks, I run Tormod.
Tormod? Okay, okay.
So, graveyard decks are usually not a big issue.
I believe you. That's fair. With the hot
honey mustard? Yeah, sideboard, the way I have it set up now, is 4 Nature's Claims,
mm-hmm.
3 Tormods, 2 more Dismembers, 3 Creeping Corrosions,
jeez.
And 3 Guttural Responses.
Yes. Rip Cryptic Command.
That's right.
Yeah. Jeez.
Screw your Cryptic Command. It's like, just because you tried to Cryptic Command, we are going to kill you now.
That's it. Oh, man.
But it works good for me.
I believe you. It looks the part. It looks that moment when they, in combat, they try to tap down your creatures and you counter it with guttural response and they're just like, done.
Yep.
Done. Who holds up mana for that? Alright. Very nice. I like this a lot. I really do. I mean, obviously, I would prefer four Glistener Elves, but, you know, in certain
meta,
something else.
I may have kept four Glistener Elves, but I don't think that I did. I'm pretty sure I kept one of everything for a Blight Mamba.
I think if it's not a four of, you can maybe cut one Necropede for another Glistener Elf.
Yeah.
Necropede is too good.
Fair enough. In certain metas, it
just,
most definitely
just
is.
Because of his secondary ability, where if you block him, he pretty much kills a creature.
That's,
and then he gets to kill another creature with him.
I think in Modern right now, he doesn't kill enough creatures consistently, though, with his minus one counter. There's just not a lot of one toughness running around these days. Not that I see, anyway.
It was mostly for Snapcasters.
Oh yeah, there was a time when that was definitely, that made the Treasure Cruise meta, where that just did oodles of work, killing Pyromancers and Snapcasters, and hopefully you'd get a Fugitive Wizard, a Delver of Secrets every now and then.
Yeah.
Alright.
And then I mainly ran the Dismembers just for Malira, but I hardly ever see Malira anymore.
Yeah.
It still works out good to just get rid of stuff.
Fair enough.
That's annoying.
I guess Coco Combo runs it every now and then. And as you can see, it really works wonders in the mirror. You look like against a Bogle's deck or something, you can just outrace them way, way too much of the time.
Yeah.
Okay.
I've only played Bogle's against this one time, I believe.
Okay.
I believe it's been once. And, they would generally present lethal, like, turn 4, turn 5.
Yeah.
But I was consistently killing them on turn 3.
That's right, that's right. What you're doing is just so much faster than what they're doing, which is by necessity. Their creatures are slower, but they get some protection built in. That's the trade-off.
Yeah.
They trade speed for, resilience. And you're just going balls to the walls, madman. The joys of being an infect pilot. Oh, I love it.
Yeah.
Next time, hopefully I'll bring my dredge deck.
Yeah.
I don't know, have you seen my Army of the Dredge deck?
Mm-mm.
Oh, it's glorious. I won't tell you to not watch it, to be surprised. You can
and
definitely
actually
watch
I run
it.
8 forests, 4 windswept, 2 Pendlehaven,
okay.
4 and 4.
Very good. And if for nothing else, this is fodder for Become Immense.
Yeah. And maybe I would cut a Necropede for put the Glistener Elf back in, but I don't know.
Alright. Well, it's 16 creatures. That's a good strong number. I sometimes wonder if Rancor might not be. Do you think that Rancor is a little underwhelming as far as the pump spells go?
It depends. The trample helps a lot, especially when added to Ichorclaw. If it wasn't Rancor, it would probably be, I really don't know, maybe just another groundswell might, maybe even just add in more creatures.
They all came around the corner.
Rancor to me seems like the kind of card you for one mana you're getting 2 damage every single turn.
Mm-hmm.
So against the control matches it seems great, but
basically.
I don't know. And the fact that CMU trample is nice, but against a lot of bigger creatures, it's just I don't know. I'm trying to think of how I remember when Ari Lax was at Pro Tour RTR, he said that it was actually, in his opinion, the most underwhelming card in the deck, and he still ran it as a 4 of.
Mm-hmm.
It was just a card that didn't do as much out-of-nowhere work as a lot of these, but it lets you play the long game.
Right.
But if you're Infect, typically, not always, but typically, you're not trying to play the long game. So I think that's the dis-energy it has. It's really good. I don't know that I would cut it. I mean, I've mentioned some cards I would replace, and I think if I had to cut a spot, it might be Rancor, but keeping some number in might still be right. Okay, fair enough. And Mutagenic Growth, Kolaghan's Command is making that card good again, because for the longest time, that card seemed really underwhelming. Lightning Bolt 3 damage. This is 2.
Yeah.
That's not enough.
It's part of my turn 2 kill with this.
Yep. Very good. Very, very good.
Turn one, Glistener Elf. Turn two, Groundswell, Mutagenic Growth.
Yeah.
Might, Mutagenic Growth.
That's it.
Might, Groundswell. It doesn't matter.
11 damage, however we're doing it.
Yeah.
Very, very nice. Good old Glistener Elf. Turn two kills in Modern, and it's not even that inconsistent. It's just Glistener Elf, two lands, Mutagenic, and two pumps.
Yeah.
Or one pump and three Mutagenics.
Which might be a reason to cut a Necropede back for the Glistener Elf, just...
Yeah.
For more turn two kills.
Fair enough. Just to threaten those decks that are just operating under the assumption that Modern is a turn four format, and so they have the first three turns to build up.
Yep.
And they just aren't doing anything for the first bit. You just say no. You need to do something. I'm gonna force you to respect me. Here you go. Like my. Mono white enchantment prison deck. It, other than Path to Exile, it's like, what am I doing? Not really anything. Which works well against a lot of decks, but not against Infect.
No.
I think my record with that deck against Infect is like 1-4 or something like that. It's pretty bad.
Yeah.
Alright. We'll see you later.